Europe. You ready for this? 2012 Europe. I went there for a couple of weeks. We're going to look at a couple of pictures, and I'm going to discuss what I've been doing lately. Okay, so yesterday I posted onto Facebook my Japan pictures from 2012. I was only there 4 or 5 days. We're going to look at those in just a moment over on Facebook to kind of recap what's been going on, as well as what else I've been doing on Facebook. But I will start you off with a little view of some of the Europe pictures that I took. I went and did a wedding in Paris, and then I drove over to Switzerland. So this is partly the drive over to Switzerland through small towns, just random small towns in France. And I didn't even know exactly where I was going. I just drove through cool little towns like this. It took a couple of days to get to Switzerland instead of just going directly on a freeway for like 4 hours, 5 hours. Took me a few days, but some of my best pictures were on the route to Switzerland, and obviously some of the pictures in Switzerland were my favorites. I'd never been to Switzerland before because I wanted to spend an extended period of time in Switzerland, so I waited until that. So I went to some old villages, and this is getting close to Switzerland, and now I think this is Switzerland. This is Geneva. Right here. This is one of the lakes with the castle, and took a few pictures there. Cool sunset. Random sheep in Switzerland. Another cool city. And driving around. As I'm driving, I took this picture of the train nearby. A couple of vantage points that I just like, whoa, hey, look, that's cool. And I think this is Lucerne, maybe? It's the one with the famous bridge. I did some night shots, and we were bummed because it was raining so much and it was hard to take pictures, but we still got some good pictures. And this is in the southern region in the Italian-speaking area. And a cool drive that some bus driver said, you should go up to this valley. And so I did, and here are the pictures. And then I went down into Italy, Lago di Como, and took a few pictures of a random town that I stopped at. Probably should have stopped at more. This was really cool. And some like typical Switzerland stuff. Big mountains, water, mountains, and countryside, and cows with the big bells, and fishermen, and mountain scenes, and more mountains, and valleys, and green, and churches, and you know. One of my favorite stops, favorite vistas, was at this mountain range. So, you do know that this is what we're doing is helping. This is my best of, as far as my opinion. There may be others that people would have liked even more. This is my opinion, so I need some data. I need people to go, hey, Scott, this is really, really good. I really like this one. You should, I've got 5 categories, Utah, West Coast, Japan, Bolivia, and Europe. I think all in all, there's like 450, even with the black and white, you know, additions and stuff like that. There may be up to close to 500. And so I am getting data. I'm sorting through it. I'm making decisions based on that data. And, well, there's the last picture. So you got to see all of them as I drove back to France. And obviously I took a lot more pictures, but these were my favorites. And I'm getting the data, and I'm going to be able to make a very best of. So now look here on Facebook. Here is an album. We will open this up, and you can go through the pictures, and you can just hit like here with this thumb, or you can go to the picture itself, and then use your arrow key, like go right, next. See the picture's really big on the screen, and then hit this like button if you think it, you know, really deserves to make the next level. This is preliminaries, you know, like the very best of, not just the best of. So where they're all grouped in together, and then we start going down from there. This is over on my Facebook business page, so Jarvie Digital Photography, if you can see right here. And so we can see some get like 3, 7, 8, and then others get like 16, and I think there's one in here, a couple in there that have 40. So I like seeing a big consensus, like, oh yeah, this is great, but if you think one, like, oh, that only has 5, you know, like, that one really deserves it. Maybe write a comment, tell me, you know, why this one deserves to make the next level. Or vice versa. I don't know. Maybe if one's got 40, you're like, no, Scott, you have some others that are better. This isn't about ripping on pictures. It's about helping to give data to figure out which, you know, deserve to be the top pictures. And that doesn't mean that I might not choose this one anyways to be the very best of, because it's still, I'm just collecting data and I'm analyzing it. This one did really well. And I'll look at it, maybe it was shared and that's why a lot of people went to it or something like that. And so, whereas some others may not be shared. Anyways, go through that. There is this one, but you can also do, if you go to my photos, so you click on photos and go to the albums, you'll be able to see the others here. So you can open up Bolivia or the West Coast or Utah. So here's Bolivia's pictures. Some have more than others. Bolivia and Europe will have quite a few. West Coast has a few less. You can look through those. And Utah. And I want to tell you, if you find one of my posts, I think I'll put the next post up, and you share that in like backlit box. And I'll put a link to them in this YouTube video. And there should be a link on the Jarvie Digital page. If you reshare that post and like backlit box, then anytime that you go and, you know, go through these images, I will enter you into a drawing, and one of those people will get a backlit box, which is cool. It's like $150, I think, value for 11 by 17 or 12 by 18 backlit box. I have one of them. They look really great. So like backlit box, and then reshare one of those posts to enter you into the drawing. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to talk to backlit box and see who the most recent people were and see if they also did a reshare. And if they did, then they're entered into the drawing how many times they liked that. So we are going to check first on them. They are the ones giving away the thing, so you should like them. You know, if you want to win one of them, then maybe you like them. Okay, so just go to them, backlit box, all one word, and then just hit like, okay? And you can see what they have been doing. They did this, and I don't know, their boxes are really cool. So anyways, I also wanted to kind of mention that over on Jarvie Digital, we have been doing these photography death matches just for fun. I did 26 of them. I had one releasing every hour, and people got really into them, but now I've got to regroup, and I'll be doing some for Japan and Europe coming up. And so you would take two pictures side by side and say which one you like the best, or three pictures side by side, which one you like the best, or a lot of pictures and decide two or three, and then I'll start grouping them down a little bit more. But you can just go to them and then hit the right arrow, and you'll be able to see all of them pop up, and you can make your decisions. They're nice and big picture, and just put in the number. It's always ordered 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you know, left to right, and then down next level. So that's what's been going on. I hope you enjoy what's going on and enjoyed the Europe pictures. This cow says hello, and I say goodbye.